Welcome back to American Latino TV. I'm Valerie Ortiz. Singer-songwriter Mayra Veronica might have been born to a musical family, but the daughter of a famous Cuban musician did not embrace music at first. Instead, she chose a route that made her a variety show star host on Univision and an almost cult status as one of America's most downloaded pinup models of the last decade. But after several years of modeling, Mayra's musical passions could not be ignored. And while independently pursuing her musical dreams, Mayra managed 3 top 10 Billboard dance hits, including her last track, Ay Mama Mia, which peaked at #1 on the dance charts. She even got signed to Simon Cowell's record label, Cycle Music. Let's just say her transition from curvy model to a dance music maven is going pretty smooth.
Sonidos, brought to you by Chevrolet.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
With dangerous curves and good looks, Cuban American Mayra Veronica might seem like just another Latin bombshell. But this Latina knows how to work not only her physical talents, but her musical ones too.
I think we had gone from high fashion models and runway models to all of a sudden the bikini model being like the thing. There was FHM, there was Maxim becoming like top sellers magazine-wise, and they contacted me. They were like, you know, we see you on TV and we know all this stuff. Would you like to be a part of it? And then that's when it all started snowballing. When I graduated from psychology, that was what my thesis was on. I was very big on saying how the feminist movement was a necessary movement. Now I think in the process, we refrained from giving female characteristics value and strength. There is strength in softness. There is strength in femininity. I think we're at a point now in society where we can express our sensuality, express our softness, and still be powerful. They're not mutually exclusive. So I start getting on all these magazines and I start getting a huge fan base. Quique Santander, who's a big Latin producer, and Roy Tavares. Roy remembered my dad and he was like, your dad was a singer, why haven't you tried music? So I started taking my lessons and my stuff and I started recording. So it started going like really, really well, to the point where I felt that I had to take it a step further. And I left, I came to California. It was all Spanish, my first album was all Spanish. I did it independently at first, eventually got signed on to a German label. So I decided, I was like, okay, while I'm doing all this in Spanish, I wanna try this out in English as well. I started putting out my stuff independently. After that, Freak Like Me landed #3 on the Billboard charts. Again, I'm gaining more confidence as I go. So my team, all of a sudden, my publicist more specifically, decides, why don't we try one of the songs that you had recorded in Spanish? Let's try remixing this and just putting it out there and seeing what happens. And it was a big track in Spanish called Mamma Mia. And the song goes #1. In the midst of that, Simon Cowell and the whole Cycle Music gets a hold of the song and really, really likes the track. And they're like, oh my God, looks like there's something here. Let's sign it. They signed me. In the midst of this whole thing, I'm signing as a spokesperson to the Betty Page clothing line, which fashion-wise, I found myself very, very happy to have found, because again, we touch back on that, on being like that strong woman, but feminine and sexy at the same time, where you don't need to have a skirt hiked up to here, but you can still be sensual. So here I am, I'm finally uniting like my image, my music, my style.
Mira que estoy tan perdida. Mira que me estoy gozando.
Not easy. I lived in my car for about 8 months when I first left my house. I had nothing. And to end up, you know, waking up to the Hollywood sign as my backyard every morning, you know, being the boss of quite a few men, it's a dream come true.
Get down, get down, get down.